Mufti Meng, where Sheikh, would you be able to share with us a few tips for parents to deal with the 21st century teenagers of today's time?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين. I think what is of utmost importance today is for us to realize that more than being a father and a mother in the sense that was understood in the 60s and 70s and perhaps 80s, we need to know that now in 2015 we need to be, yes, a parent who is also a friend of our own children, who tries and understand the child and plays a very, very big role in the life or in the lives of our own children. It's not good enough to have children and never see them except in the weekend for a few hours. It's not good enough to have children and never be bothered to ask them questions, to answer their questions, to guide them in terms of the type of friendship they should be making. It's not good enough to have children and not show them or teach them by example, where they will never see you fulfill your salah, they never see you in the way you speak and your mannerisms, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed on your shoulders, the minute He has blessed you with offspring, the fact that you need to be their role model to start with. And the way this will be achieved is by playing a big role in their lives. So they watch you speak, they watch you behave. To be honest, many of us, may Allah forgive us all, many of us, in the presence of our children, we prefer to be on our phones, on our mobile phones. Is it a fact? Is it the truth? I heard a yes, mashallah, quite a loud one. We prefer to be on our mobile phone so the child speaks to us. And you know, I know an example of one child who was speaking to his father, and the father was busy on the phone. And he kept on saying, "Dad, you know, this morning I had this and I did this, and whatever happened, happened, and this is what occurred, and I ended up doing this and that." And the dad's just nodding his head, you know. Okay. The nodding of the head is coming. He says, "Yes, okay, yes, yes." He doesn't even know what the child is saying. So the child says, "I tested my dad and I said, 'Dad, you know, you're quite a big idiot, you know.'" And he says, "Yes, yes, you know, yes." He's just nodding his head. If this is the attitude that we have, then what do we expect? I mean, you know, the children would rather message us when they want attention to say, "Dad, I'm right next to you." And then you've got to look up and say, "Oh, okay, yes." But you receive the message on your phone. So we do have a deficit sometimes in our own children when it comes to attention and when it comes to you know, proper parenting. It's important for us to make sure that we do not leave that to others, because the vacuum that is created can be filled by anyone. And if it is filled by someone online, beware. You have people out there who might be preaching that which is absolutely unacceptable under your nose. And the reason why, or some of the reasons why the children fall into these traps, is because we did not fill what we were supposed to fill, so we have created a vacuum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all, may He strengthen us, and may He make us parents who are successful in these most challenging times. Indeed, it's become more very difficult to bring up children. I would like to think because, you know, a few years back you had to worry about the type of friends your children kept. And that was one of the most important things. Right now you have to worry about how they use the internet. You have to worry about what they see, what they don't see. And a lot of this can be remedied by us playing a big role in the lives of the children. May Allah help us to be of those with sound character and conduct that our children can watch and emulate, inshallah. And even the choices we make for our children, the types of schools we send our children to, plays a big role also in how they will grow up. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability to pray for our children, because no matter how hard we try, without the acceptance from Allah, we won't be able to achieve much. Wallahu a'lam.